Hi there, guys. It's Peggy Hogan, and just wanted to touch base, talk to you a little today about one of my favorite topics. I mean, I think most of you are learning now that shaping is the cornerstone of my training. I've been doing a lot of clinics and online clinics with Monty Gwen. Shaping is the cornerstone of her training. So it's really fun to see how we are offering this amazing technology to a variety of people. But along with that topic, I absolutely love working with start buttons. I was in on the foundation of bringing this information to horses. Really grateful that I'm able to share that. And another topic that's near and dear to my heart is working with multiple horses. I did a lot of training at Liberty when I was using pressure. I was involved in natural horsemanship for many, many years, and I still liked working at Liberty with multiples. I've got some fun footage from those days. But when I switched to clicker training, it was a bit of a wake-up call, because here again we have the food, and the food is a very compelling motivator of behavior, right? And things like resource guarding suddenly become forefront for us as trainers to figure out, oh my goodness, how do I deal with this horse that now wants these resources, and then the behavior escalates when other horses are around. It can be dangerous, and I'm a real big advocate of learning how to work with multiples on a very, very safe, methodical approach. And I have these classes that I've been offering for years, multiples, and they're basically three different modules to it. Last year we got through module one and two again, and I am so excited to say finally module three is going to be on the agenda. Going to start working with that. I have a guest speaker with that, and she is amazing. You should see some of the things she's accomplished with working with multiples, her multiples, and that's Anat Shalev. She'll be joining. Monty Gwen is going to join in as well. And I just want to share with you that it's a multi-pronged approach, but the people that are going to participate in this last class have some basic behaviors in place, and we've been building towards this. It's no secret that I think using stationing as a default behavior is an amazingly effective way of keeping ourselves safe. And you can see my horses will take a look at me, and I walk into a situation and there being horses and running around, and they will look at me and, oh, it's what's her name, let's go stand on these stations, because we'll get what we want. That means they're in control of the resources, and they're in control because they offer a behavior that's well reinforced and well established and has lots of history to it. I learned this from Ken and his lectures years and years ago. So, and I did a lot of research when people weren't training multiples with food. His book had some amazing, interesting material on what it's like to work with multiples of all these different species. And I thought one interesting thing he said was that some of the trainers really focused on feeding, and I'm throwing you out a tidbit here. So some of the trainers focused on honoring the established order that the horses have created. So if we have horses that are, one horse is used to being the one that's to the food first and eats, that's the one we focus on training. That's the one we make sure that has the strongest behaviors of stationing and the other behaviors we train as protocols for keeping ourselves safe. Don't get mixed up in the well, it has to be fair, because we can actually end up taking a horse that would be, let's say, second or third in line to eat. We will end up setting a situation where that horse has more aggression directed towards him than if we just quit trying to be fair and fed the one that is most likely to eat first. That was a real eye-opener for me to read that in his animal training book. And other people with other species in working in multiple situations had decided that this was a good protocol. So I've been using that protocol. There's a little fun tidbit. So when I do the multiples class, it's a really, really fun process. And by the time we get to the one that I'm about to offer, we can start adding fun things, things that you've probably seen me do in videos, in some of the dance videos I've done, some of the performance routines that I've done with more than one horse. And those are, it's a blast to work with more than one horse in a setting where they're both working towards a common goal and we don't have to be worried about resource guarding. So thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next class. And also be aware of the fact that shaping is a foundation behavior, and we have ongoing shaping classes so that people can take those and then join our other classes. We also have a foundation course that I think works with everyone's needs, which is shaping behaviors, teaching movement behaviors so we can get our horses to quit being statues, which often happens with people who are trying to train calm. And then we also have putting these behaviors on cue so that then we have horses that aren't throwing behaviors at us. They actually know when to offer these behaviors. These three courses, I think, are absolutely necessities for anyone that wants to get into this process using food with their horses. So, see you online. Glad to have you in our classes.